Hello everyone, Iris France here. And next, we're going to talk about the determinants of price elasticity of supply. Here is the first determinant of price elasticity of supply: how easy it is for a seller to adjust the quantity. I want you to put yourself in the shoes of a seller. Suppose the price goes up. Of course, you have an incentive to produce more. But are you able to produce a lot more quickly? If you're selling 10 soaps, then you just let the factory run 24/7, then you're able to produce more, and that's great. But if you're a builder and you are selling beachfront houses, then there is only one coastline. You are not able to squeeze a lot of houses in front of the coastline. So you get it, if you're able to increase the quantity quickly, like 10 soaps, then the price elasticity of supply is going to be great. But if you're not able to adjust the quantity quickly, then your price elasticity of supply is going to be lower. Like beachfront houses, you are just not able to squeeze that many houses in front of the coastline. So the price elasticity of supply will be lower for beachfront houses. The second determinant is time. The shorter the time period, the more inelastic your supply. The longer the time period, the more elastic your supply. Why is that? Because time allows you to produce more, and time also allows you to cut production. And therefore, the more time you have, the more elastic your supply is. Here is the immediate short-run supply curve. Suppose you own an apartment building which has 100 apartments in there. If there is an increase in demand, well, in the short run, you only have one apartment building. So if you don't want a shortage, the only thing you could do is to increase the rent. Here is a short run supply curve. You can see that this is already a little bit more elastic than our immediate short run supply curve. So the definition of short run is this: the time period in which at least one production input is fixed. Think about restaurants. In the short run, the kitchen size is fixed. You cannot change it. You can always buy more or less ingredient to prepare more or less food, but the size of the kitchen is fixed. So in the time period when you have at least one production input that's fixed, we call that short run. And here is our short run supply curve. You can see it is still pretty inelastic, but it is more elastic than the immediate short-run supply curve. Here is our long-run supply curve. You can see that the supply curve is a lot more elastic than the supply curves we saw before. So the long run is a period of time in which all production inputs can be changed. So for example, in the long run, if you're doing a great business in restaurants, not only that you can expand your kitchen, but you can open restaurants in different locations. So we can see that in the long run, because all inputs can be changed, and therefore our supply curve is the most elastic. And here is our summary. The longer the time you have, the more elastic your supply is. In year 21 and 22, we often heard about supply chain crunch. What does that mean? Well, that means after the pandemic, there is a demand shock. Demand increases from D1 to D2. And in the short run, because firms cannot quickly adjust the quantity, so what they could do is just to raise the price. With time, our supply is going to become more and more elastic, and the price will also go down.